Good morning, Bucknutters. Welcome to the Bucknuts Morning 5 here on Friday, June 7th, 2019. I am Dave Biddle. Very happy to be joined by Jonah Booker for his usual Friday visit. JBook, my man, you caught some waves this week, and I don't think you did anything wrong. The Kendall Milton situation, you know, I just want you to address this for the listeners out there. His father, Kendall Milton, the five-star running back who Ohio State, every insider seems to think, at least most insiders seem to think that Ohio State is the team to beat for him. Kendall Milton's father, Chris Milton, took exception with some of the comments you made on Twitter, and basically all you said was you thought Ohio State was the team to beat, and you know, maybe he was, you know, close to a done deal to Ohio State, but he was going to take all of his visits, and Chris Milton took exception to that. Just your reaction to that, JBook.
Yeah, it was interesting to say the least. I was actually riding a shotgun coming from Tucson and was reading Bill Kay's update, which I thought was fantastic. And based off what he had written in his article, that was my interpretation of what the comments was sounding like to me as a reader, trying to figure out, you know, how the visit went. And from all indications, the visit went extremely well. Ohio State hit it off the ballpark. And if you're to take what Bill Kay had written in his article, that's kind of what I was interpreting it as. Now, did I think it was going to be something way over the top where a parent of a recruit or, you know, the fanatical Georgia fan base or just blow up my timeline? No. But hey, he's a parent and I don't blame him. And he wants to make sure that he's given every school equal opportunity. He wants to take the visits. They want to keep their word. On my part, I wasn't trying to put words essentially in their mouth. I was taking it as this is what the article was written as, and this is what I, as a reader, take from the actual article. But hey, you know, as a father, he wants to go ahead and make sure he's putting a shield around his son, which is reasonable and expected out of a good father. So good for him.
I was going to say, you hit the nail on the head there. I think really, you know, like I think what you said was absolutely true. Again, and you were just really repeating what Bill Kerlick was saying on our site. I think Chris Milton probably just agrees with you deep down, but he wants to be a man of his word and give these other schools a fair shot, even though he might feel like deep down Ohio State's the team to beat. He doesn't want to let the cat out of the bag yet, which is hard to do in this day and age. And he wants to give those other schools a fair shot. So I think you nailed it there. I think we're going to look back on this and laugh. Hopefully we'll get you guys together at an Ohio State tailgate here in a couple of years when Kendall Milton is running the football for the Buckeyes. But I think you nailed it there. I think he knows you're right, but I think he just, you know, wants to give these other schools and these other coaches a fair shake.
And I'm not going to sit there and go back and forth with a recruit's parents on Twitter. I mean, I let that man go ahead and say what he has to say. But the last thing that I'm going to be doing is going back and forth with a parent over his over interpretations of words that he has spoken in a Bucknuts article. That's the last thing that I'm going to do. So I, you know, remove myself completely from the situation. I'm not going to respond to him or Georgia fans or whatnot. So we'll see how it plays out. You know, if he becomes a Buckeye, great. Hopefully he has a tremendous visit with those other schools. In the end, Ohio State did enough to sell him. But the recruitment process is all going to be about the relationships that Ohio State built. Is going to be about what Ohio State can offer as far as playing time, education, comfort level. You know, me interpreting Bucknuts' article on Twitter is not going to have any type of bearing on where this kid chooses to go to college.
Very well said and very classy on your part, my friend. You said what you said, and then you just stayed out of the fray. I think probably 95% of the people in your shoes would have jumped in there and just made it, you know, even more interesting situation. You took the high road and the classy road, and I think you will be proven right in the end anyway. And again, we'll get you guys at a tailgate together and we'll all laugh about it in a couple of years. Ohio State had their first big camp day yesterday. They're really their first camp day, the one-day camp yesterday, the first of several camps will have this month. What a huge month for recruiting it is for the Buckeyes, as we all know. You know, Paris Johnson and Darrion Henry showed up. Paris Johnson was going to work out, but he has like a little minor sprained ankle, so he decided not to work out. Darrion Henry did work out. And I guess Paris Johnson's mom was spending a lot of time with Ryan Day and Jeff Hafley. That was the big thing, JBook, as you know, when Urban Meyer retired, it was like for Paris Johnson, his mom, it was like, oh man, it wasn't just losing a legendary head coach at Ohio State. They were closer with Urban than maybe the typical recruit. And you can see why, with Paris being best offensive tackle in the country and an Ohio kid, they already had a really good relationship with Urban. So, but it sounds like Ryan Day and Jeff Hafley have done a great job. And this is going to be, especially Ryan Day, of course. Jeff Hafley's just there, just hanging out today and mostly recruiting the defensive guys. But Ryan Day's done a great job forging a relationship. And, you know, at this point, JBook, I'm going to be surprised if Paris Johnson's not a Buckeye.
Yeah, I like where Ohio State's sitting right now. As you mentioned, them on campus spending time with Coach Day, I think that's huge. Obviously, Day has been working his tail off to really mend that bridge that Urban had with the Johnson family. So just being able to, you know, let them know what type of man he is, what type of coach he is, what type of vision he has, is going to be huge. And I agree with you. I think in the end, he'll be a Buckeye as well as Henry. And the thing is, it's just also getting Henry surrounded by Coach Johnson and his GAs, so just seeing how he goes about his business as far as coaching the defensive line, and also helping those younger guys develop. So I think that's going to be big, but you have to love that they're actually on campus. Another guy that I'm really excited about is Reed Carrico, the Ironton linebacker, who's absolutely blowing up. He's, you know, visiting campus today, not working out because of a sickness that he has, but just getting him on campus when he just received an Alabama offer yesterday, as well as the big boys from LSU and Florida State. I always joke with my Ohio brethren back in Southern Ohio, anytime you can get those big time powerhouse schools coming up to the recruiter River Rat, you know he's a ball player. So just seeing the offer list that he's starting to rack up and getting him on campus, which he will arguably be the number one top Ohio recruit in the 2021 class.
And you can say that as a proud original resident of Portsmouth, Ohio, where you were a star football player. My wife's side of the family is all from Portsmouth. I know I've told you that. And I know, you know, obviously I think the listeners pretty much all know now that you live in the Phoenix, Arizona area, but yeah, you are a original proud member of the Portsmouth River Rat community, I will now call it that. Don't call my wife a River Rat, though.
Then Ironton was one of our big rivals down the road there on the river. But it's good to see a kid from that area really blowing up. But he's a big-time prospect. He's going to be a top 100 national recruit, probably, you know, easily top two recruit in Ohio in this class. But he's an absolute animal. I mean, the guy is – you know, 6'3", 230 linebacker that can really play with some aggressive nature that you want to see from that linebacker position.
Yeah, and you touched on Darrion Henry. I mean, there was a lot of blowback with, you know, 24/7 drop in his ranking. You know, he's still ranked as the number 117 player overall in the country, according to the 24/7 Sports Composite. Number 11 defensive tackle. Originally was listed as a D end. I think we all knew he was pretty much going to grow into a D tackle anyway, but whatever. Number two player in Ohio. And as you said, it feels like I don't want to get in trouble with Darrion Henry's father. It sounds like it's almost a done deal that he's going to be a Buckeye. What do you make of just all of the backlash about, do you feel like there was any, you know, do you agree with the drop of the ranking? Were you kind of taken aback by it as well? And just why are you confident he'll be a Buckeye?
Yeah, I didn't agree with the rankings. I thought that was a little too harsh to drop him that far. I mean, to me, I think he's a guy, when you're looking at him as far as rankings, which a lot of these rankings are, is basing it off what you project this guy to be. Do you think he's going to be able to be a prime time player, which I truly believe he will be and he can be. And especially with the coaching of Larry Johnson, he will get the most out of him. And I think if Larry Johnson can get the most out of him, I truly believe that he will outplay his rankings once he's on campus. Now, as far as him being the done deal, just joking, you know, that's a touchy subject. We don't want to get anyone fired up here, but I think the chances are for Ohio State, they're looking extremely well in that recruiting front there. So the thing is I really don't care Forse about the actual ranking of him. I just want defense recruits on board and in this class. Obviously, there's been so much talk about the lack of defensive recruits with this class. Obviously, they're knocking the ball out of the park when it comes to offense. I just want to get some defensive bodies, and especially an in-state kid who I think has the potential to be a heck of a football player.
Yeah, I like what Bill Green said the other day on the show that, the you know, right now the bases are loaded with nobody out as far as, like, defensive prospects that could be Buckeyes. You know, are they going to, you know, hit into a ground ball double play and they only get one run out of it? Or are they going to, like, have a big inning and get, you know, six or seven or eight commits out of this? And it's going to be a big month. And I tend to think it's going to be more toward the six, seven, or eight than the one. It might be – it's going to be somewhere in the middle maybe, but I think it's going to be a lot more toward the – six, seven, and eight. Maybe they'll get to six this month, but I do think the floodgates are about to open to a certain extent. I want to close the show talking about a guy that seems to get dogged a lot on Bucknuts, a kid that's a commitment to Ohio State, Trey Leroux. And you know, it's human. People look at rankings, as we know, JBook, and you know, he's not even ranked in the top 1,000. If you look at the top 1,000 kids in the country, Trey Leroux's not listed. He's like barely in the top 50 in Ohio. But this is a kid that's 6'9", 350 pounds, out of Norwalk, Ohio, and you just can't teach that size, 6'9", 350. And he was at Ohio State's camp yesterday, and following along with what Bill Kerlick said, he more than looks the part. I mean, I'll take a kid like this. If you're going to take like a flyer on a kid, you know, give me a kid like this any day. It's a lot like Matthew Jones from – or not Matthew Jones. I'm forgetting the kid's name. DeJuan Jones, yes, DeJuan Jones from Indianapolis. And that kid is a great basketball player with good feet. If you're going to give me somebody who's low ranked, give me kids like that every day. But I love hearing that Trey Leroux's out there yesterday doing a really good job.
Yeah, and you have to like that from a kid who's already in the class but wants to get better at the position. Obviously, he has a long way to go. He's very raw. He's going to need to be coached up. But as you mentioned, give me a kid with that size, and if he's coachable, then I will take those type of prospects, especially in the state of Ohio. I mean, how many times have we seen throughout the last 20, 25 years where you had low-rated kids really turn into absolute gems? The coaches saw the potential in them, and once they got on campus, you can't teach heart. And if this kid can show up and he's willing to work, and everything that I've seen in regards to the way he goes about his business and his attitude is he is hungry to be great. He wants to, he's not just happy that he's committed to this class. He wants to be a great football player. And anytime a kid is willing to be coached up and they have a mind frame and an attitude that they're not just going to settle for what they have already accomplished, they want to accomplish more, then you take those kids and you give them a shot. A 6'9 kid in state, nay, I will put him on that offensive line with Jones, and you may have your future bookend tackles there.
And if one of them of the two works out, then you're happy. I mean, it's like almost baseball at that point. You're hitting .500. You're more than happy with that. I am more than happy with Jonah Booker, as always, dropping great knowledge, getting parents, recruits fired up on Twitter. He does it all. He is Jonah Booker. Thank you very much, JBook. And thanks to all the listeners out there for tuning in to the show. I appreciate it. Hope everyone has a great day and a great weekend. Let's hear that Buckeye swag, best damn band in the land. Fire, 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 fire.